Unbelievable. What a Grand Prix.
The world of MotoGP can be fickle, unpredictable, and very uncertain during any situation. And this is especially true when a race appears to be set in stone, only for a late twist to turn the race upside down at the very last moment. So, we have searched through the archives and come up with 15 times that late race drama has changed the complex of the race and affected the final result. The most recent example of this scenario came at the last round, the Portuguese GP, where the two behemoths of MotoGP came together in the closing stages.
Oh, and they've both gone down! Oh, unbelievable! Pecco Bagnaia was not going to give that one up without an almighty fight, and there is contact.
We didn't have to wait long for fireworks, did we, between Marc Marquez and Pecco Bagnaia. Bagnaia going for that very cutback that we were talking about earlier. Of course, he tried it on Acosta earlier on. The gap was there to try and slip back up the inside of Marc Marquez. Marquez just didn't want to release the gap.
And the rising star found the podium in only his second race.
Can you believe his high side on the dirt? And that's going to put Pedro Acosta on the podium.
He's already got an issue there, hasn't he?
He's got a problem.
He doesn't think that's the last lap like a race last year, because he's lost a lot of ground there. He goes wide into turn one. Surely Maverick Vinales doesn't think the Grand Prix is over here, does he?
Surely he doesn't. And then he spits him in the air. What late drama we've had here in Portimao. And Pedro Acosta, the rookie sensation, after Maverick Vinales' late, late crash at the start of the final lap at the first corner, Acosta is on the podium in MotoGP.
Technical gremlins may have ruined the podium hopes of Maverick Vinales, but for his teammate Aleix Espargaró 2 years earlier at the Catalan GP, his ride to a home podium was undone in dramatic fashion on the final lap.
Aleix Espargaró's got a problem, can you believe this? On the last lap, Aleix Espargaró is withdrawing from this Barcelona Grand Prix. On the last lap, he got his hand up. We just saw there, Jorge Martin came through on him down the main straight.
When's he got his thumb up?
Does he think the race is finished? I think he thinks it's over. Oh my goodness, can you believe it? What a howler by Aleix Espargaró. We thought it was a mechanical. He thought the race was over. He's made an incredible miscalculation. Aleix Espargaró thought his home Grand Prix was over. He thought he'd taken second place. That's one of the most incredible blunders I've ever seen. It's going to be head in hands for Aleix Espargaró. He comes over the line and takes the checkered flag in fifth place.
Home heartbreak doesn't come as hard-hitting as losing the race on the final lap. And unfortunately for Alex Crivier, the race wouldn't pan out the way he would have expected, as the Spaniard entered the final lap in the lead of the 1996 Spanish GP. However, as he and arch-rival Mick Doohan entered the stadium section, the pair found some unexpected obstacles.
There are fans on the track already. This is incredible. Since I've never seen anything like this in my life, and that's not helping Crivier at all. Down into the Cardos for the final time. Can Doohan make a dive free? He's going to. Here comes Mick Doohan. They're going to go to the final corner. They touch, going in there on board with Crivier. Oh, Crivier's gone down.
Alex Crivier crosses out on the very last bend. Mick Doohan wins the Spanish Grand Prix here at Jerez. What a race. What an ending, Luca Cadalora third.
Incredible scenes here with fans on the track. Alex Crivier goes down in the final corner. He looks set to win his home Grand Prix. And he's going to have something to say about that. It will be a little bit frosty in Repsol Honda tonight.
The final race of 2011 played out as many did that season. Casey Stoner, now a two-time MotoGP champion, leading the way, and by lap 21 had a 10-second lead over his teammates Andrea Dovizioso and Dani Pedrosa, both battling for third in the World Championship, with Yamaha's Ben Spies hot on their tail. The race for the win looked sewn up, however, this was about to get interesting. The rain slowly began to fall, and as the race entered its closing stages, Ben Spies began eating into Stoner's lead. The American capitalising on his opportunity with three laps to go.
Whoa, very wide for Stoner through turn six, and Ben Spies takes over the lead in the Valencian Grand Prix.
Through turn 14 they come, the very last bend of the new season. And Casey Stoner tries to put up alongside Bansfield.
Oh, who's it's Stoner who wins! Coming out of the final corner, I do not believe it!
Oh, Casey Stoner pulls it out of the bag at the very last metre of the race.
How far he's come from!
Well, I never. From one American missing out on the dream to two chasing victory at the 2006 Dutch GP. Nicky Hayden was looking for his second MotoGP win, and two-time World Superbike champion Colin Edwards his first. It was Kentucky versus Texas as the Kentucky kid closed down long-term race leader Edwards.
Nicky Hayden up the inside on the brakes. Nicky Hayden takes the lead. Edwards has run off the track. His chances of winning his first MotoGP race have disappeared. Nicky Hayden not only leads the World Championship, he leads the Dutch TT here at Assen.
The race looked over for Edwards with a lap and a half remaining. However, the Texas Tornado had other ideas.
Colin Edwards is going to throw caution to the wind. Colin Edwards on the Yamaha closing up on Nicky Hayden. They're coming up towards the left-hander now. They're into the right. Edwards side by side, and Colin Edwards has retaken the lead. Edwards has retaken the lead from Nicky Hayden. Colin Edwards chasing his first ever Grand Prix victory. They're into the chicane. Oh, Hayden and Edwards side by side. Edwards holds the advantage. Hayden's got into the dirt.
Unbelievable.
Nicky Hayden crosses the line. Colin Edwards has gone down in the dirt, would you believe it? Colin Edwards had the checkered flag in sight. Colin Edwards has crashed out of the Dutch TT here at Assen, and Nicky Hayden has won the race. Here we go, let's watch it again. They're side by side. Edwards takes the lead. Hayden comes up the outside and is going to dive up the inside when they flick it right any moment. Now, here he comes. He's going to try and ride around the outside of Edwards. Not able to do so.
And Hayden runs across
the chicane, and Edwards runs across the outside of the chicane and runs off the track. That's a very, very interesting situation. So Hayden in the dirt. Oh, and Edwards just catches the AstroTurf, runs on the outside of the track. The Yamaha runs on, and Colin Edwards goes down.
The 2015 Argentina GP was a race of two halves. From lap one, Marc Marquez running the hard tyres opened up a four-second lead. However, by the time Valentino Rossi moved into second on lap 11, running the extra hard rear tyre, he began to close in on the Spaniard, and with two laps remaining, the doctor made his move.
93 against 46, Rossi on the brakes. Rossi up the inside, Marc Marquez had a bit of a moment on the brakes going into turn five. Rossi leads contact there between Marquez and Rossi. Marquez is down! Marc Marquez has crashed out of second place in the Argentinian Grand Prix. Well, they touched on the exit of turn five. As Marquez and Rossi went to flick into turn six, Marquez clipped the back of Rossi and the world champion is down. I really don't think Valentino Rossi can take the blame for that incident, do you? We will find out. Mike Webb and Race Direction will decide that. This is the key moment of the race. Contact there between Rossi and Marquez as they exited turn five. And you can clearly see that Rossi was ahead of Marc Marquez when they collided on that run through that to turn six. His second Grand Prix victory of the season for the master, the doctor, Valentino Rossi.
Only 1 year later, the closing stages of the 2016 Argentina GP would end in drama as Ducati teammates Andrea Dovizioso and Andrea Iannone entered the final sector on the last lap.
The Ducatis have crashed out together. What a gift for Valentino Rossi. Now, we don't know who was the instigator in that final crash, but what a disaster for Ducati. Andrea Iannone and Andrea Dovizioso out at the final corner. So he's pushed it over the line.
13th place. Well done, Andrea Dovizioso. Here we go, Iannone up the inside. Oh, Iannone, I think, to blame, don't you? Into the side of his teammate Dovizioso. They both go down.
Marc Marquez entered the 2013 Australian GP on the verge of making history as the youngest Premier Class champion and the first rookie since 1978. If the Spaniard left Australia 50 points ahead of Lorenzo, he would be champion. But the newly resurfaced Phillip Island circuit had other ideas. The race was shortened from 27 laps to 19, and riders had to make at least one pit stop and run no longer than 10 laps on one set of tyres. However, as Jorge Lorenzo made his pit stop in lap 10, Marc Marquez continued.
Marquez has stayed out there! Marquez has stayed out on the track! I do not believe this, but surely Marquez has gone a lap too far. What is going to happen now? That must be a miscommunication between himself and the team. Marquez runs and gets back into the race. Surely we think a lap too late.
Here he comes. Has he got out in front? No, Lorenzo will still lead the way. It's going to be touched. Oh, they've touched.
No, they
in
really
the two and
have
corner.
Touched.
They touched then in the two and corner as he came out of pit lane.
Yeah,
and Marquez now runs it a bit wide.
Marc Marquez has been black flagged. Marc Marquez will not be getting any points. And if Lorenzo wins, it will be, oh my goodness me, it will be 18 points separating them in the championship with two rounds to go.
He's been black flagged because he ran over the time, didn't he? He came in one lap too late. The 2013 World Championship has been blown wide, wide open.
Oh, disappointment. 43 points, the lead is about to be hacked apart.
Jorge Lorenzo wins the Australian Grand Prix here at Phillip Island, and he has blown the 2013 World Championship wide, wide open.
Phillip Island 2013 wasn't the first time a championship leader had been disqualified in the third to last round of the season. 15 years earlier, this happened to Max Biaggi, but under different circumstances. The Italian was caught overtaking under yellow flags after an opening lap incident, and with six laps remaining, was awarded a stop-and-go penalty. However, the Roman Emperor refused to serve the penalty and was subsequently disqualified from the race. But this wasn't the end of the story.
Oh, and he is so close behind Doohan. The privateer Honda is going for the lead. Max Biaggi retakes the lead of the race, and it won't do him any good at all.
There he goes,
black flag
more.
Number six. And he actually rode over towards them. Final corner for Mick Doohan. He is going to take the victory, but he is not going to cross the line first. That honour goes to Max Biaggi, but Mick Doohan takes the win, and most importantly, to retake the championship lead.
As the 2021 Catalan GP was entering the final stages, championship leader Fabio Quartararo was all over the rear tyre of KTM's Miguel Oliveira. But the race would take an unexpected turn.
Oh, he's almost lost the front there, and he's shaking his head. It's going wrong for the world championship leader. He might just lose another place here to Jack Miller as well as he rejoins the circuit. This is not what we thought. Well, the bookie's favourite, Fabio Quartararo, doesn't look like he's winning the Catalan Grand Prix.
Is he a bit uncomfortable? He's got his leathers open there. What's going on? Quartararo has got some sort of issues. He's taking his chest protector out there of his leathers.
Guys, has his zip come down?
Weird, how strange. Well, there was a move from Miller up the inside of Quartararo.
Yeah, you can see.
Yeah, his zip has come off.
You can see his necklace and his bare chest.
What's going on? What's happened to the leathers here of Fabio Quartararo with three laps to go?
Oh, as Quartararo has got a three-second penalty. His podium has gone.
Miguel Oliveira wins on the factory KTM here in Barcelona ahead of Joan Zarco and Quartararo, but he will not finish third with a penalty. Miller moves up one spot.
Three Italians chasing home GP glory at Mugello with only a lap and a half remaining. What could possibly go wrong?
On the outside he goes,
to the inside
of the track. Rossi's going to go through, and he does. Rossi goes over and takes the lead in the Italian Grand Prix now. So Rossi now leads from Capirossi, and Biaggi in third place. Still the three Italians battle it out. Still, who will come out on top in this race? Just a lap and a half remaining. Valentino Rossi down!
Rossi's down! Valentino Rossi crashes out. Oh. Biaggi going to switch to the inside, and he's going to take Lawrence Caparossi for the lead. Biaggi takes the lead with just half a lap to go, but Caparossi fighting back, and he's going to be very, very late down in Terra Biata. Here comes Caparossi.
Capirossi's going to go back through in front of Rebbiati, and he does, and they're both side by side in the corner. They've touched, they're going in, and Biaggi forced wide, and Capirossi takes over at the front.
Capirossi just takes a slightly turned line, pushes Biaggi out, there's nothing that... Biaggi's down!
Max Biaggi goes down, what disappointment for Yamaha. Capirossi looks round, he's already celebrating. Loris Capirossi on board the Emerson Honda Pons machine, number 65. Loris Capirossi victorious in his home Grand Prix.
The 2023 Australian GP will go down as one of the biggest climatic finishes of the MotoGP era. Jorge Martin looked to be on course for a dominant victory after leading the race from lights out. However, the Spaniard had gone for a soft rear tyre, and in the final few laps, the performance fell off a cliff. And the chasing four riders behind, which included Martin's championship rival, Pecco Bagnaia, all running the medium tyre, had slashed Martin's 3.5 second advantage to just under half a second as the last lap began.
Martin leads by just 0.4 seconds.
I don't think John Zarco's going to have a choice here, Matt. I think he's going to have to either pass Jorge Martin or be passed by Bagnaia.
He has to make the move. Does he go for it here into the middle corner?
He
does on the inside. Martin might even miss the podium here.
Bagnaia,
Bagnaia could be taking the victory. What an incredible last lap here. High drama in Phillip Island. You can throw a blanket, a tissue over the top five. Out of Siberia we go. Jorge Martin was, what, eight corners away?
He's going to be off the podium
victory.
Now.
He's not even going to finish on the podium. That soft rear tyre has destroyed itself. What a race. What a circuit. Binder on the inside. But Johann Zarco, finally, we can say the flying Frenchman is a MotoGP winner. Get ready, folks, because here we go. The Frenchman's backflip is back. Johann Zarco celebrates in style.
Aggregate racing is a phrase that has been confined to the deepest depths of history, to fans. And for many, even the slightest hush sends shivers down the spine. However, we must unlock the unspoken phrase one more time for this one. After 52 years, the 2001 Rio GP played host to the final ever 500cc race before the MotoGP era began. On lap 5, the race was red flagged, and when part 2 began, the times from both parts were combined to get the final result. This would play a significant role in the outcome of the race when Carlos Checa, who was just behind Valentino Rossi after the first part of the race, entered the final lap in the lead.
Checa has got a prize open a few more metres if he's going to win this race. What a delicate situation it is. Rossi thinks about diving up the inside, decides not to. I would think he's pretty safe there to win the race overall. They're coming up amongst the back markers. It's Anthony West that could get in the way. The young Australian could play a vital part in the outcome of this particular race. Under the bridge they go, into the final right-hander. And West is there. Checa's trying to get past him. Checa's through, also Rossi is through. Who is going to win the race? They cross the line, it's Rossi! Rossi has won the race from Checa by 0.143 of 1 second.
When MotoGP entered round 5 of the 2017 season, Valentino Rossi was leading the championship, just 2 points ahead of new teammate Maverick Viñales. And although Rossi had the points advantage, the young Spaniard was arguably the strongest of the two in the early rounds after taking 2 wins while the doctor didn't have any. So it was up to the legendary Italian to assert his authority.
He's going for it, he's through! Rossi is through to take the lead! Viñales sweeps around the outside, there was a little bit of contact there. The crowd are going absolutely ballistic here in Le Mans. To come down the hill towards the right hand.
Rossi's wide! He tried to run a defensive line. Valentino Rossi tried to cut a tight defensive line. We record him on, surely Rossi's not close enough at the blue S's. It will have to be turns. Oh, Rossi's down! Valentino Rossi's crashed out of second place.
Rossi down and okay. Maverick Viñales will win the French Grand Prix. What a race we have witnessed once again. Viñales wins his third Grand Prix of the season. Maverick Viñales takes over the lead in the World Championship.
2021 Austrian GP has to go down as one of the most bombastic finales in MotoGP history. And it all started as the rain began to fall with just over 3 laps to go.
These guys are almost at touring speed. It's like an in-lap here. Marc Marquez, so gentle. Look, barely any lean angle from him through turn number 9. Oh, they're all coming
apart
in.
Apart from Binder.
Binder's gone for it. Binder is the only one that's going to stay out on circuit. These are all changing tyres. There are 4 laps remaining. Marc had a good look around his shoulder. Wow, what a show the Austrian fans have got here. And Brad Binder crosses the line leading from Aleix Espargaró. They're now in second place. Wow, I can't keep up. This is incredible drama. Incredible. Now then, keep your eye on Miller and Rins because they've all already got wet tyres on. Ooh, a bit of a stuttering flag-to-flag bike swap then from Fabio Quartararo. Late drama here in Spielberg. We were expecting a Spielberg blockbuster. That's exactly what we've got. Brad Binder then gambled. He stayed out there. He saw the top 5 men ahead of him peel into pit lane. Here they are. Marquez, Bagnaia, Mir, Quartararo and Jorge Martin. You've never seen anything like it. So unpredictable is MotoGP. And they exit pit lane on wet. Now remember, Binder is out on slick tyres. What does he do? What does he do? Well, how hard is that rain falling? It was falling hard enough to convince this top 5 to come in. Bagnaia has made a mistake straight away out on his spare bike. He runs in hot at turn 3.
Well, he needs two laps to go.
He needs it to stay like this, really. He's doing, what, 1:34. Let's try and check on the lap time to Marquez. Aleix Espargaró at the moment, he stayed out there as well.
And Rossi's on the podium!
Rossi's on the podium at the moment, ladies and gentlemen.
That would be his 200th
Premier Class podium. Can you believe it? Absolutely incredible.
What are we watching?
Rossi in a podium battle with Lecuona and Marini. Oh, my goodness. Anything could still happen here because it's raining in different sections of the circuit. There are 2 laps to go here in Austria. Yeah, Marc Marquez is 31 seconds behind Brad Binder.
Oh, he's down.
He's gone down, pushing too hard into turn 1. Marquez's podium hopes, they've completely gone. Quartararo also was well wide. Valentino Rossi then, 5th. At the moment, here's Lecuona on course for what will be an absolutely sensational podium for him. Potentially 2 KTMs and an Aprilia on the podium. They can't believe it.
Oh, he's wide up the hill.
Oh, this is high. Can you believe what we're seeing here? I've never seen a race like this in my entire life. We are on the brink of something extraordinary. Brad Binder, slick tyres.
Oh, he's almost down sideways.
Look at that. No lean angle whatsoever. He was almost down. Slick tyres on a soap Spielberg circuit. Oh. And somehow Brad Binder's keeping himself sunny side up. Ladies and gentlemen, Brad Binder could be on for a win in the wet on slicks. Aleix Espargaró for Aprilia could be getting their first podium. Ika Lecuona might be getting his maiden podium, but it's not over. He's got to use all of his motocross skills here. Look at these guys
Aleix
all battling for second and third.
He might be losing a podium here. I think he will lose a podium because Lecuona all over him.
The Aprilia man. Can he hold on? He's so nervy, so tentative on the brakes. They're almost at a standstill. Valentino Rossi might just go for broke here. He's just at the back of this group. This is the battle for the podium, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Binder has gone through sector 2. He's now coming through sector 3. He's just corners away from winning his second Grand Prix on KTM's backyard.
Well, we're on course in KTM's backyard for a KTM 1-2.
Lecuona second. Luca Marini now.
Look at Bagnaia.
Bagnaia's on the wet.
I can't believe what
he's going to get a podium. He's going to cruise by these guys. They're on slick. He nearly runs into the back of Ika Lecuona. Bagnaia's going to get a podium. Where's Brad Binder? Here he is. He's going to do it. The checkered flag is out, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Binder wins in KTM's backyard on slicks in the wet.
What a Grand Prix. Can you believe it? Pecco Bagnaia is going to rescue a second place. Who's going to take third? It looks like it'll be Jorge Martin. The men on wet tyres are going to be on the podium. Bagnaia does take it. Martin gets a podium. Mir 4. Marini on slick, somehow 5th. Lecuona on slick, 6th. Quartararo on the rain tyres was 7th. Rossi at one stage, we thought was going to be on course for his 200th Premier Class podium. What an extraordinary tale.
What's that? Do one more, click here to subscribe.